Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. Yeah, in today's video, I want to talk about if you as a photographer should shoot for free, what are the pros and cons of shooting for free, and overall, what I do when I photoshoot with models and if I personally shoot for free. I hope you enjoy this video. You can of course also subscribe to my YouTube channel here. Don't forget to ring the bell. Yeah, without any further ado, let's begin. So first of all, what exactly means shooting for free? There's actually a term which is also known as TFP. Some say it means trade for print and others say it means trade for pictures. And basically what it means is that when you're a photographer and you shoot with a model, you offer your service for free and in exchange you receive the images. For example, the same goes when you're a model, for example, you offer your service for free, you work with a photographer and in exchange you receive the images. For the pros, when you start out with photography, either being a model or a photographer, it has a lot of advantages because when you have no portfolio at all, it helps you to build up your portfolio and you can also create your brand. And when you are beginning as a photographer or a model, it's very hard to find photographers or models who want to work with you because you are just starting out and you have really nothing to offer. So shooting for free is a good idea because you can gain a lot of experience. Both of you can benefit, so it's a win-win situation for the photographer and the model. But on the other hand, I have a lot of negative experiences with shooting for free. And that is, for example, that when a model texts me, for example, on Instagram and asks for a free photo shoot, I feel sometimes not worthy enough because I put a lot of effort into my pictures. And I know it's totally fine if you ask a photographer if you want to shoot for free, but I don't see it if I have to like edit 15 pictures. And it's very hard because a lot of models use photographers and they say like, oh, I'm your best friend, we can shoot for free. But in reality, they just use you to be their photographer. So when you shoot for free, you should always make sure that you also get something out of it. And this is what I always do. I always ask myself, is it worth it to shoot for free? So this is something you should bear in mind. And another point I realized is when shooting for free is that sometimes some models don't put a lot of effort into the pictures. For example, they arrive at the photo shoot location tired because when you pay for a photo shoot, it's entirely different because you put something onto the table and you know, as a model, if you don't give it your all, it's not worth it. And when you shoot for free, as a model, for example, and this is what I experience, is that the models don't really put a lot of energy into the pictures and they like, oh, okay, just another photo shoot for free. So this is a huge advantage I notice, and it's something as a photographer you should be aware of, that when you shoot for free, it doesn't always mean you get better pictures. This is what I notice. And furthermore, what I also think is that when you shoot for free is that you also make a lot of losses. For example, on every photo shoot I shoot for free, I also have to like, use a lot of space on my hard drive. And memory on my hard drive is so expensive. I pay like for 4 terabytes around 100 euros and I have to do that maybe every 2 months. It's important that you find your niche as a photographer and never devalue yourself. This is important because you as a photographer, you are worth it and you have a worth, and don't trade everything for free. So this is what my intention is. And also I got a few tips for you. This is what I do and still do, because when I shoot for free, I always make sure that, for example, I include the footage into my YouTube videos so I can make money long term, because I shoot still for free sometimes because I see value in the photo shoot. I can use, for example, the footage for my YouTube channel, and long term I can make, for example, money with Google AdSense. And one last tip I got for every photographer who wants to make a bit of money is that you ask for at least a little donation. Like you could say, for example, hey, I'm willing to shoot for free, but maybe you can give me a little donation of 15-20 euros so I can buy a new storage for my computer. This usually always works, or you could say I'm saving up for a new camera lens. Could I get a small donation of maybe 10 euros? Because then it shows that the money goes into your equipment, and I'm pretty sure a lot of models would just give you a small donation. And this is what I did at the beginning, that I asked for a small donation and it sums up, and then you can buy new camera equipment, new lenses. I honestly tomorrow have a free photo shoot, and yeah, I'm looking forward to do it. And I know the footage I make through this photo shoot for my YouTube channel will be more than enough for me to get better and better, and long term, yeah, to make more money. And yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. And guys, if you have any questions about shooting for free, about photo shoot content, you can leave it in the comments down below. You can subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, make sure to ring the bell. And guys, take care of yourself, and see you next time.